2021. So today we will continue by looking this exercise, which is exercise 6.2, page 66 from this book. Okay, so 6.2, which is this one. Okay, so the question asks, determine the moment of the forces. We have two force, so two forces about point P. Okay, moment about point P created by these two forces. Okay, all dimension is in meters. So we have been given this one. Dimension here is 4 meter, 3 meter, 10, and so on. Okay, we have two forces. The first one 400 newton. The other one is 520 newton. Okay. So before I go, normally I will looking at this one. We see that all the component we can convert all the component here into x and y direction. Okay. For example, this force. Okay, we can resolve into x and y direction. This y is already in x direction, and meaning that later on we want to find the d, okay, f times d. So d also must be in x and y direction for easier calculation. So directly now, from before even calculate, I will transform all the forces, all the dimension, distance in term of x and y direction. Okay, so here we know this dimension, but we didn't know from here. So we have 30 degree. So here will be 4 sine 30, here will be 4 cos 30. Okay, and here we have been given 5 and 12, so meaning that I can calculate what is the angle here. Okay, so the theta is equal to, so we do it tangent minus 1, 5 divided by 12, so we have angle of 22.62 degree. Okay, so now I can resolve this force. One into x and the other one is into y direction. So instead of having this force, I will resolve, one will go here, x, the other one must go to this direction. Okay, that's why it is important. The previous chapter, you know how to resolve the forces in term of axis. Now we want to resolve in x and y direction. You want to maintain the original in between the two resolving forces. So we have this one and two, and now we know the angle. So this one will be 520. We take this angle 22, so cos 22.62. The other one is 520 sine 22.62. I just put the magnitude of it, the direction, you don't mind for the moment. Okay, you don't mind now, is it positive or negative, we just leave it as it is, because we already show the direction. So that this direction 522 sine, this one 520 cos 22.2. Okay, now that we have all the forces in x and y direction, and the distance also in x and y direction, and then we can calculate the moment. Okay, now we want to calculate the moment about point P. So let's go. We have moment about point P equal to, okay, we know that moment is equal to F times D. Okay, now we have several forces, so that there will be positive and there will be negative. Okay, and again, there are some students who confused about the positive and negative direction. Some said, some students will see, for example, this one, they see that it is negative direction of the x. So they will put the moment because of this force as negative. That might be true, that might be false. Okay, because the positive and negative direction of the moment didn't directly influenced by the positive and negative direction of the force. The force might be opposite direction of positive x, but it create the moment positive in the motion of the moment clockwise, so it might be positive. Okay, so don't directly say, okay, this is the negative of force, so negative of moment. No, because the moment itself, okay, positive and negative, it depend on the direction of the rotation. So here there might be some negative, some positive. So I have to choose one direction that I consider as positive. Now my clockwise is positive direction of the moment. Okay, so let's go one by one. This one we have force to the left. Okay, this one, if we take the positive force to the right, so this one must be negative. But the moment created by this force might not be negative, depend on the direction. Okay, so is it positive, is it negative? So we have to look at this one. We have the point here, and we have the force pushing this direction. So it is same like this one. I have, let's say, this is the point, and this is where my force P is. So when I'm pushing this direction, you see that it will have the tendency to move, okay, to rotate clockwise. So the moment created by this force, actually, positive moment, okay? So it is 400, okay? Pushing, put a pin here, pushing this direction, so it will turn clockwise. Or if you look at this one, from this force, okay, you want to go to this point, so the shortest angle must be directly to this one, so positive direction, okay, positive direction. So 400 is the F, you want to find the D. What is the D? Okay, the D, 400 times the D. D is the distance between this line of action of force to this point 90 degree. So the easiest one, normally what I will do is, I make the first line, on the, which is the line of action of force. I make the second line that go through P but parallel to this one. So the distance between these two lines must is my distance D. So in this case, our D is 3 times this one. So this is the D. Okay? So D is 3 plus 4 cos 30. Okay, this is my first D. And then this is finished. We go to this one. Now I have the pin here. I'm pulling this one upward. Now my force is positive if you look at the positive direction of the Y. But if I'm pulling this direction, you see that the component, okay, here, this is the pin, this is the point, I'm pulling that direction, it will move, it will have the tendency to move counterclockwise, okay? So if it now, okay, or if you take it from here to go to this point, it will go this direction, which is counterclockwise. So moment created by this force is negative. So negative, the force is 520 cos 22.62, negative here, because pulling goes this direction to go to here. Okay, so negative, that is the force. What is the distance? Distance, this is your line of action of force. So this is the line, this is your line of action of force. Okay, now I'm going to do to go here, which is 90 degree to this point, or I make the second line here, which is parallel to this line. And the distance between these two lines is my D, okay, which is 10 plus this one. So this 10 plus this one. This is the length. So it is 10 plus 4 sine 30. Okay. 10 plus 4 sine 30. And then we have the last one, which is this one, 520 sine 22.62. Okay. Imagine we have this point, we put a pin here pulling this direction. So somewhere, let's say I'm here, this is the point here pulling this direction. You see that it tendency have to move the clockwise. So even though the force is to the left, but because it will pushing the component to move clockwise, so this moment created by this force is positive. Okay, positive and negative here refer to this one. I'm putting the positive direction as clockwise. So if it turn counterclockwise, we put negative. If it turn clockwise, we put positive. So the force 520.62. This one. What is the distance? Again, you make a line on the force itself, which is line of action of force, and we want to find the closest, the shortest distance between this line toward the point P. So what I'm doing is, I'm making this as the first line, okay? And then I will create the second line parallel to this line that pass through P, so which is this line, and this is my distance, okay? I apply same thing to other forces before, okay? So this is my distance, which is in this case, this is the distance, okay? So the distance is 4 cos 30, okay? So now we have all the forces times the distance that become the moment, and we know the direction, positive and negative. Okay, so we calculate that one, maybe 400 times 3 plus 4 cos 30, 3 times equal to minus 2 times 520 cos 22.62 times 10 plus 4 sine 30 sine 23. Okay, minus plus 520 sine 22.62 up 4 cos 30 1 2 and 3. Okay, so it is from here I get equal to negative 2481.53 Newton meter. I get a negative, meaning that it is opposite from my positive direction here. So the answer is moment at point P is equal to 2481.53 Newton meter. Okay, opposite from this one, which is counter clockwise. This is your final answer, which is you must have the magnitude and the direction, because it is a vector unit. The moment is a vector unit. So magnitude, Newton meter, and the direction is counterclockwise. Okay? So again, we have the equation, which is moment equal to F times D, because we have several forces, so that might be positive and negative, so you have to choose one direction as positive direction, as a guideline. So you can put it here, if it is follow the same direction, this one, if it's positive, it is opposite, it will be negative. Positive and negative, clockwise or counterclockwise, depend on this one. If you imagine you put a pin and put a pin at that point, you pull force, or you push from the force here, and you see which direction you turn. Or the other way is you take the shortest the angle from the point from the forces toward the point, and you see that which direction, positive and negative. Okay, in this case I have resolved everything in x and y direction for easier calculation. So you can also using this force 530, but you have to find the length, which is same as this one. Okay, the length which is same as this one, 90 degree to this line. Okay, which might be a little bit complicated. So it's for me in this case it is easier to use or resolve everything in x and y direction. And then lastly, if you get negative, meaning that it is opposite from your positive direction, so your final answer must indicate the magnitude and the direction. Okay, so that's all. Thank you.